rhythm and snooze. It was I was rhythm and Greg was snooze. So they had finished up with me and the Warrior, and they were going to then, they had finished with Greg as the cream team, or dream team, and they said, we'll put you guys together, we travel together, Jimmy Hart was managing, so, and then they said, Greg, you need to have black hair. So they quickly went in the locker room one night, dyed his hair black, and they said, we need a name, and we're thinking, I'm thinking, Pat says, we need a name really quick, and it's like, you guys are on in 2 minutes. And Ravishing Rick Rude is sitting over, he said, I have it, rhythm and blues. Honky's rhythm, and Greg is always snoozing like blues. And Pat said, I like it, let's do it. So they ran over there and they told the people in the TV truck, and that's how we did it. Consequently, Greg did not put his best effort into it, as Billy Gunn didn't put his best effort into Rockabilly. When someone doesn't want to do anything, then they don't put their best effort. And if you don't put out the effort, you're not going to get any results. Especially, you're not going to get positive results. So Greg was, he didn't really want to do it and everything. And now he tells me, I wish I had worked harder at that. We could have probably stayed there a long time. They were going to put the tag belts on us. We were going to beat the Hart Foundation for the tag team belts until they got the Road Warriors came in. But anyway, he put the black hair on Greg, and he says, I hate this black hair. He kept saying, I hate this black hair. Any of you seen Valentine lately? He says, I swear to you, I'm working at a car show. We had 10 of these World of Wheels car shows, these big car shows that they have around them. They have them all over the world. I had 10 of them booked. We're in Atlanta on our second show. And I had 8 more to go. Somebody went by at the table. It was me, Virgil, and Greg. And he said, they took a picture. They take it up front, show the promoter. Promoter comes back to us, says, somebody took a picture of you guys sleeping back here. And Virgil said, it ain't me, man. You know me. I've been with you for a couple of years. I said, well, it sure wasn't me. He said, that guy was sleeping. He said, pack your shit, you're done. I said, what about Dallas? What about our other shows? He said, you're done. Now, that's a whole bunch of shows on your calendar that's canceled. He was taking somas and all that shit. He said he was depressed. You're broke and you need money and you're depressed and you take shit and you sleep. Rhythm and snooze. So I said, why don't you like the black hair? I can't get any pussy. Girls don't like black hair. I said, why are you worried about getting women? You're married. I said, I've had black hair for 30 fucking years and it ain't stopped me from doing anything. But anyway, he didn't want to do it. If someone does not want to do something, and Billy Gunn did not want to do the rockabilly, it will not work, folks. It just will not work. It's like pulling teeth. And you want to be there, and you want to be with the company, you want to extend your career for a little bit longer, then, you know, I mean, this is not the worst thing. It's to dye your hair black and go out there and act like you're singing. He didn't know the words to any of the damn songs. So that was it. He's rhythm, I'm snooze, and I say it every time. Then I said it to him on sitting there with him the other day. Now he's taking what's this shit he's got? They don't take the somas in Xanax. Oh yeah. I'm so depressed. Depressed? I'm broke. But you're begging for bookings. Why are you taking these depression things? I'm not taking them anymore. Why me you had to do? I've cut back only 6. Okay. I had him booked 30 miles away one night in Denver, Colorado. This was in August. I had him booked. He begged me, please book me, please book me. I had him booked. I said, the guy will be here at 3 o'clock to pick us up. We're doing a Comic-Con. 3 o'clock, I said, here comes the guy. He said, I don't think I'm going. I said, it's only 30 minutes away. You're going to make like $500. We're only going to be there for a half hour, sign autographs and leave. I don't want to go that far. I said, if you fuck me on this deal, I'll never book you again. And I told him last week in Milwaukee, he said, why don't you book me on that tour? I said, because you fucked me in Denver 3 months ago and I'll never book you again. Now go back to sleep.